Hey guys, thank you so much for tuning in today. First of all, I just want to thank you so much for all your comments. Please keep them coming since it really encourages me to make more of these videos. I also want to help you guys learn as much as you can, so I've actually created a dedicated Facebook page where you can post your work or post any questions you might have for the community to answer. We're all on this XR journey together, so please like and subscribe and join our Facebook page so we can continue to make cool shit together. Anyway, here's your video. In the last tutorial, we learned how to make our own component using the structure that Aframe has provided. So far, we've only managed to print out what's in the schema, which begs the question, how do we actually make a component that affects the entity itself? The component would need to have access to the entity and the scene itself, right? Well, it turns out they do have this level of access. So if you go to the documentation and scroll down and click components under API, you can see what access level each component has under component prototype properties. Components can read their own schemas using this .data, which we've covered in the last tutorial. An important note is that you shouldn't modify the data in the schema attribute directly. So what that means is you shouldn't go something like this.data.bloodtype equals red. Just keep that in mind. The next thing is components have access to the entity which they've been installed into. So essentially, if you go this.l, then it should print out an HTML element of the entity that it's been installed into. The element also has access to the scene. You can access it using this.l.sceneL, which we'll use a bit later. They also have access to their own ID. And this is really important because components can have multiple instances. So for example, if you go back 2-3 tutorials, we use animation, and you can have multiple animation components in one entity, and you differentiate them by going, like for example, go animation underscore, and you sort of instantiate it somehow. I'm just gonna write something random, and then you can write animation. This is the name of the component, and this is the name. This is the ID that we've given the component. It basically gets the ID of the component itself, not the entity. So just remember that and know the difference between the two. Okay, awesome. So I want to try use one of these access points. So first of all, I want to print out the element of each entity. So you can see the difference. I want to put an ID to each A entity. I love the famous five when I was growing up, so I'm gonna name these entities after the characters. My favorite character was probably George, and my other favorite character was Julian. I used to have a crush on Julian, actually. I know he's fictional, so my life was just very sad. Okay, so now that we've added the ID, I want to use this.l to print out the element, the HTML element of the entity. So I'm gonna go console.log this.l. That is all you need to do. So go back, refresh, and there it is. You have George and you have Julian. But that's not all you can do. You can actually use the ID of anything in the scene and actually grab that entity and print it out on another. For example, I want George to grab Julian's entity and print it out. Let Julian equals document dot query selector, and I'm gonna put Julian's ID, which is just Julian. Okay, and then I'm gonna go console dot log Julian. Silly me, Julian needs to be in quotation marks, of course. Or it's gonna think that it's a variable. Okay. Okay, great. So now you can see that George has access to Julian And obviously, because we don't have any logic behind it, Julian has access to Julian. You can see really quickly how this can be really, really powerful. But that's not all. You can also add event listeners onto components. How I'm gonna do this is, first of all, we need a cursor. I haven't gone over this yet, but I will in the next few tutorials. So to set up a cursor, you go a camera, and then you need to put a cursor. We've got the cursor now, and you can see that it's this little circular thing that you can point at different objects. So now I want to add a click event. So then when you click on each box, it should print out something. Let's just make it up. How do we normally do this? So I'm just going to start commenting my code, adding event listener, this dot L, because we're referring to the entity that the component is in, right? So this dot L dot add event listener, and you're going to open black brackets, select the event. So this time I'm going to put click. Then I'm going to add a callback function and a semicolon. And then in the function, I'm simply going to go console.log. Hello there. Okay, so now if I rerun the code, go to the console, you get hello there. So just because we want to cover all the access points, I'm just going to write let data equal this dot data. And then I'm going to go console.log data. That should just work. Yep, there we go. AB type oxygen low. A type oxygen level high. So now we've proven that event listeners actually work, which means that you can use any other event listeners like mouse enter and whatever else is available on ordinary HTML and CSS. But right up to this point, we're still just printing stuff out. We're not actually making anything happen in the scene. So let's make things a little bit more interesting. I want to make it so when I click the cursor on one of these boxes, it changes its position. To do that, we need to use getAttribute and setAttribute. Sounds familiar? That's because we use the same thing to change up CSS in normal HTML, CSS, JavaScript. We need to do a little bit of tweaking on our event listener so we know exactly what we're clicking on. To do that, you simply add an argument in the function. I'm going to call this obj console.log obj. Alright, so we know exactly what we're dealing with here. It gets the object of the entity that you just clicked on. That means we can do things with this entity now. We can go get the property, get the component that we want to change. In this case, it's position. Let all position equals obj.src source element dot get attribute. And where did I get this source element from? So if you go back here and you look down, you can see that source element is the A entity. So this is what we want. That's where I got it from. So I got obj.source element dot get attribute. And what we want to get is the component, which is the position. Okay. If I go console.log and you print out old position. Then you get the X, Y, and Z values as you expect. Okay, so then how do I change it? So then you just go obj.src element.set attribute. And then you want to change the position to, I don't know, let's copy the same thing. Let's make x 0. That's what we're gonna do. Okay, so now if I go over it again, click, there we go. It's moved to the center. And then if we click on the red one, there we go. It's actually moved to the center too. Okay. So what if we want to use what we can actually access from get attribute? So for example, if I want to make it so when I click on the block, it incrementally moves up by a certain value. It's pretty easy. All you have to do is really change the Y value, right? That's what you want to do. And because we have the old position, we can actually change that. So I'm going to make a new variable and call it new Y, since that's what we're interested in. And then we're going to use the old position. So old position dot Y plus 0.2, because we want to move it by 0.2 meters up. And then I'm gonna change this. So you've got 0, then you append it to the new Y value, and then you append that to the original, like this. I'm gonna use old position dot X, because the X value is different for each one. Then I'm gonna append a space to it. Now, hopefully, there we go. It just stays in the same spot and it moves up. Same as this one, it should just work. So there you go. I hope you learned something. Please hit subscribe and I'll see you in the next tutorial. Hey guys, just a quick update. I've been super, super busy pivoting my business to focus more on AR and VR. There's gonna be a lot of new stuff coming, so please hit subscribe, like, and hit the notification bell so you can stay updated. Building the XR community on this channel really means a lot to me and brings me a lot of joy. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.